Donetsk airport was a red line the separatists knew when they took it so quickly. Ukrainian military jets alone flew over it. Paratroopers moved in, separatists too. Oddly, both sides agree how this started. An Su-27 fired two strategic bombs, this separatist said, echoing a Ukrainian official. This man adding it was inhuman to bomb a suburban area. Locals caught in this. Those explosions, clear sign of the continuing intense gun battle around the airport. The worst violence, really, that this key population center in eastern Ukraine has seen since the start of this crisis, and coming hours literally after Ukrainian President-elect Petro Poroshenko says he'd like to negotiate potentially a way out of this crisis. Separatists, well-armed, disciplined, trained, amassed, facing a Ukrainian gunship. They fire at it and it hits a target, then comes back.
Banking away. He's turning around.
Rural suburban worlds ruptured. His family say they support the separatists who protect them.
As you can see over there in that roof, one of the stray rounds has landed into a house where fortunately there was nobody there at that time.
Police stopped traffic, but not the separatist busloads flooding in. Both sides later claimed they held the airport. But the fire burning here, just as Kiev's new leader calls for peace, hints at how Ukraine may be rushing headlong towards collapse.
Michael, we're in such a different world than we were simply 8 hours ago, where it seemed like the new power in Kiev perhaps might be able to negotiate this through with Moscow. This violence is unprecedented for this large city. People are very worried that it's the opening of something new. There are increased reports of militarized men all around this city and fear tonight of continued attacks. Even we are hearing from officials too. One person shot dead, two injured at an altercation at a railway station here as well. Real fears we're seeing the start of some new violence here, a new phase, rather than, as hoped this morning, a gateway to diplomacy.